Hey boys and girls, I am so glad you have joined us today for our time of worship. Oh, it's going to be so exciting. We've got a new series we're going to be starting called Bugs. Oh, I'm so looking forward to this, and I hope you are too. Hey, let's get ready. Let's worship our Lord and Savior right now.
Hey everybody, my name is Mosquito, and I'm here to tell you about my new virtual reality video game called Splat. Some games have you finding fake animals and creatures, but mine, you're finding real creatures, bugs to be precise. The slogan is, gotta catch 'em all entirely. I had to add that last line in for legal reasons. Anyway, each bug kit comes with a bug guide, bug catchers, and pajamas. Oh, no, wait, those are mine. Today, we're gonna do a demonstration on how to play the game. With these state-of-the-art bug catchers, you'll find all sorts of bugs, which is a goal of the game, but the ultimate goal is to find the bed bug. When I was a kid, my mommy used to say, good night, sleep tight, don't let the bed bugs bite. Ever since then, I was obsessed with finding a bed bug of my very own, so I created the game. Today, we're in my backyard looking for bugs to catch. Oh, how silly of me. You're probably wondering what a bed bug looks like. Well, you see, that's the problem because I've never actually seen one, so I drew this picture of what I thought they might look like. See? Oh, hang on. I think I see something. You know what that means. Time to put on my virtual reality goggles and say, gotta catch 'em all entirely. I feel good about those tosses. Let's go see what we got. Applesauce. Let's see what's in the other one. A fish? Ugh, yuck. Let's see what's in this one. Oh, it looks like we did catch something. Let me check my bug guide. Let's see. A ladybug? No. A Kit Kat? No. Oh, I know what this is. This is a praying mantis. They call it a praying mantis because its hands are in the shape that looks like it's always praying. Now, I don't know if it's really praying, but it can serve as a great reminder to us. Every time we see a praying mantis, we can be reminded to pray to God. You know, sometimes I forget how important prayer is, but that's what's so cool about bugs. They're small creatures, but they can teach us big lessons. Prayer is and always will be our connection to God, so we should pray every chance we get, and the praying mantis can remind us to do that. Well, I better set this little guy free back into his natural habitat, but I have heard that praying mantises are delicious. Oh no, I was wrong. I may have gotten that fact wrong, but I do know this. Today in your lesson, you're gonna learn about when to pray, how to pray, and why you should pray. It's gonna be amazing. Well, until next time, gotta catch 'em all entirely.
So with Hello, class. My name is Professor Busby McFly, and I am a bugologist, which means I study insects every day to determine what valuable lessons they might give us in order for us to become better Christians. Today's bug is the praying mantis. Now, this bug is very interesting because of the way it looks. You see, it has very big bulbous eyes attached to a triangular head, connected to an elongated body with wings on the back, and it also has two forearms. When I mean forearms, I mean the two arms in front, not the four on the bottom, which means there are six arms total, which are actually legs. But they look like they're praying, but not all six, only the two forearms, which are the two, not the four, I think. Probably. I don't know. But what that does remind me is the power verse for today, which is, keep on praying. 1 Thessalonians 5:17. Bazinga! That power verse was superlative. Now, what I need is for all the boys to stand to their feet and say the power verse on the count of three. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Keep on praying. 1 Thessalonians 5:17. That was fantastic, boys. You may sit down. Now, all the girls stand to your feet and say the power verse on the count of three. Here we go. 1, 2, 3. Keep on praying. 1 Thessalonians 5:17. Fantastic job. You may be seated. That power verse is a good reminder of how important it is to constantly be in prayer. When your life is good, you should be praying. When your life is bad, you should be praying. When you accidentally mix concoction X with concoction Y and you accidentally make a mutating caterpillar, you should really be praying. Trust me. Now, I need everyone to stand to their feet and say the power verse on the count of three. 1, 2, 3. Keep on praying. 1 Thessalonians 5:17. Excellent job, everyone. You may be seated. Well, that's it for me. I'm back off to the lab to study another bug while I'll be reading books like a bookworm and searching for articles on the World Wide Spider Web. Until next time, this is Professor Busby McFly. Bye!
What's up?
Aw, yeah! What's up, everybody? It's me. It's the SKI to the WTLAF. Skittles in the hizzy, and I'm ready to get busy telling you what's up. I am so excited to be starting up this brand new series called Bugs. We're gonna learn some big lessons from some small creatures. Today, we are talking about the praying mantis. So every time somebody asks you, what's up, you tell them. P-R-A-Y, lift your eyes up to the sky and pray. A lot of people, they don't understand the idea of prayer. They think you have to pray a certain way in order for God to hear them. Dearest Lord, most omnipotent Father God, up in the firmament of the heavens. The truth is, no matter where you are, you can always call on the Lord. Hey God, can I order a pizza? No, man, you don't need a cell phone, a satellite, or nothing. All you need to do is call on God in prayer. He'll be right there, ready to listen. So anytime, I mean anytime, somebody asks you what's up, you tell them. P-R-A-Y, lift your eyes up to the sky and pray. And that is what's up. I got a rainbow flavor, and I'm living for my savior. Skittles is out, baby. Yo, everybody, what's up?
All right, here we go. It's our time for our What's Up review. All right, girls, at home, let me hear you. What's up? P-R-A-Y, lift your eyes up to the sky and pray. Awesome job. Okay, boys, here we go. At home, what's up? P-R-A-Y, lift your eyes up to the sky and pray. Great job, great job. Okay, here we go. Everybody, at home, I want to hear you. What's up? P-R-A-Y. Lift your eyes up to the sky and pray. Awesome job this morning. Hey, we got one more song, and I'll be right back with our lesson for today.
The splendor of a king, clothed in majesty, let all the earth rejoice, all the earth rejoice. He wraps himself in light, and darkness tries to hide, and trembles at his voice, trembles at his voice. How great is our God? Sing with me, how great is our God? And all will see how great is our God. Yeah.
right, boys and girls, our topic for today has been prayer. All right, so this morning, we're going to talk about why we pray, when to pray, and how to pray. All right, so let's start with our why. But first, I want to kind of compare prayer to this cell phone. Everybody knows what this is, right? And why we use the cell phone. It's so we can call somebody else, so we can hear their voice, right? Well, that's why we pray, so we can talk to God and so that He can talk back to us. All right, so in James chapter 4 and verse 8, this is what it says. It says, come near to God and He will come near to you. That's why we pray, just like we talk on our cell phone, all right? It's so we can come near, we can hear them, all right? So that's what we do with prayer for with God. That's why we pray, so we can be near Him. All right, so number two, when to pray. Well, just like the phone, when can we use it? I don't know. Well, let's see. Let's see when we can use prayer. All right, and in Psalm chapter 5, verse 3, this is what it says. It says, in the morning, Lord, you hear my voice. In the morning, I lay my request before you. Let's see. Let's read another verse. Acts chapter 3, verse 1. One day, Peter and John, y'all heard of them? The two of the disciples? All right, well, they were going up to the temple at the time of prayer. At 3 in the afternoon. Morning, afternoon. Well, I got one more verse. Matthew 14, verse 23. After he, and he being Jesus, had dismissed them, he went up on the mountainside by himself to pray. Later that evening, he was there alone. So when to pray? Those three verses, morning, afternoon, and evening. Just like the phone. We can use it anytime during the day, anywhere we want to. And that's how we can do with prayer too. We can pray anytime during the day, anywhere we are. We can always pray and spend time with God. All right? So thirdly, how to pray. Well, just like this phone, for you to call me, you have to have the right number. You can't just throw out a bunch of numbers on a phone and hit, you know, the dial and who knows who you're going to get. But if you don't have my number, you can't get me. So you know what? Just like with God, if we don't have the right number, we can't get to Him either. So let me read John chapter 14, verse 6, okay? And listen carefully. This is what it says. Jesus answered, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father, talking about God, except through me. All right, so just like the phone, you have to have the right number. Well, with talking to God, you have to have the right number. You know what that number is? J-E-S-U-S, Jesus. The only way we can get to God is through Jesus. How amazing is that? As we accept Him into our lives and into our heart, He is the in-between us and God. And He allows us to have that daily conversation with Him, just like we talked about when, morning, afternoon, and evening. All right? So, prayer. Right now, let's go. Let's pray. Let's spend that time with God, just like what we've been talking about today. Let's pray, all right? Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank You for this day. Lord, we thank You for this lesson on prayer. Lord, knowing, Lord, that why we pray, Lord, that it's so we can spend time with You. Lord, that we can share our feelings with You. So, Lord, back in return, You can share with us. Lord, and just thank You for that. We can take any time during the day. Lord, as we talked about in these verses, Lord, that is morning, in the afternoon or the evening. Lord, no matter what time of day it is, Lord, You're always available to listen to us. And Lord, we thank You for that. And Lord, we thank You for Your Son, Jesus Christ, because Lord, He is the way, Lord, that we get to you. Lord, he is the right, quote, number, Lord, that we have to get, Lord, to your ear. Lord, that you will be able to listen to us each and every day. Lord, we thank you for that. Lord, I just ask that you would be with us. Lord, be with these boys and girls this week, Lord, that they'll go through the day and remember, Lord, that they can pray anytime. Lord, that you're always there to listen to us. Lord, be with us this week. Lord, keep us safe, keep us healthy. Bring us back to another time of worship next week. And Lord, we just look forward to what you have for us this week. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Hey, boys and girls, I don't know about you, but I really enjoyed this lesson on prayer. And Lord, I just ask that you would spend some time with God today in prayer, like we just talked about, all right? Just share with him and let him share with you. All right, so remember our power verse for today. 1 Thessalonians 5:17. Keep on praying. Hey, we'll see you next week. God bless.